Hello friends, welcome to Letstute accountancy channel. Today we are going to learn why Excel is important for accountancy. To watch more such videos, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get regular updates. If you want to become master in accounts, you should know Excel perfectly. At least the Excel command which is used in accountancy, that is most important for understanding and presentation of data. Okay, first important is Excel is used for daily business operation. When there is no Excel software, that time we are preparing report by way of calculator. Okay, today morning 10 a.m. we are starting to prepare a financial data, and today evening around 5 p.m. we are doing calculation and our report is completed. Okay, so morning 10 a.m. onwards, evening 5 p.m. onwards, okay, our management is waiting for the financial reports. Okay, to avoid this, to save the time and to take the decision on time, Excel has given a multiple type of facilities to prepare your report so that you can give more importance to time and more importance for decision making purpose. So most important technique first is, that is mathematical and financial calculations. Within a second, Excel is giving mathematical and financial calculations. I'm saying that within a second, giving mathematical and financial calculations. Please note that Excel is giving more importance to time and decision making purpose. Who is the decision making purpose? Management. If the report is perfect, then management will take the decision. Next important function of Excel is analyze and visualize data in charts, graphs and pivot tables. One of the best technique in the world to present a data in pivot table. What is the importance of pivot table? If your input data is perfect, user has to visualize his reports, what type of column first required, what type of data required, so that report will be perfectly presented and management will take the decision. For example, if your data present in pivot table and based on the report, if you see that my salary cost is increasing, my production cost is increasing, so management will take the decision why my cost is increasing. My installed capacity is 1 lakh, but based on the presentation, it shows that only 80,000 production is done. Okay, my installed capacity to produce 1 lakh goods, but based on the report, it shows that 80,000 production. Why it is? So management will take the decision why this type of happen. Okay, also Excel has facility to forecast company growth also, whether my company is doing profit or not, okay, whether my revenue is increasing or not, okay, my fixed asset is utilized properly or not, okay, my production cost is controlled or not. Excel has a facility of cost control techniques. Okay, now the most important function is Excel is also used for budgeting functions and preparing financial statement and other reports. Based on the budgeting, management is analyzing entire year my expenditure cost, budgeted expenditure cost, and entire year my revenue cost. Okay, based on the financial data, you will analyze that how much capital to be invested and what control, what action we should take based on the report. Okay, so also Excel is most important for what system needed and what changes to be implemented. It's really important for the management, for decision making purpose. And last and the important function is Excel has facility of import and export of banking information, financial data. If banking software is exporting data in Excel format, then Excel has facility to import the data for preparation of your financial data. For example, bank reconciliation statement. It will be auto prepared if you properly set the columns and rows and the other numerical data, you will get financial report easily. To understand the entire Excel function, you should know the basic of Excel. Okay, so let's start it. Let's learn it, the basic of Excel. I have given different type of operators which are used in Excel. First operator is arithmetical operator, that is plus sign, minus sign, multiply sign, divide sign and percentage sign. Okay, the first operator is plus sign. Okay, if you want to calculate your employee cost, the command is salary and wages plus bonus plus staff welfare and reimbursement. I have given screenshot also. Okay, let's do it in Excel sheet. You can give plus sign or equal to sign, answer become the same. Plus sign is used during the Lotus software. Okay, then Excel software come and Excel has given facility of equal to sign also, plus sign also. Okay, so I am using plus equal to sign, selecting cell number D22 plus cell number D23 plus cell number D24. Okay, your answer is 11,35,821. That is your employee benefit expenses. Okay, I have used operator plus sign. Okay, now next operator is minus sign. I have given screenshot also. To calculate your net profit, formula is total revenue minus total expenses. Okay, this is your profit and loss account, this is your total revenue, this is your total expenses, and here I am giving the formula. I am selecting the cell D7 minus D15. Okay, so my profit or loss is -7,54,346. Okay, now the next operator is star is multiply sign, divide sign, percentage sign. Here I have given a screenshot of fixed asset schedule. Here I have given the formula. Okay, so let's start in Excel. Okay, this is my fixed asset schedule. Okay, suppose if you want to calculate depreciation on furniture, okay, please note that there is no addition during the year, same closing balance is there. Okay, and your depreciation method is straight line method. Okay, I am using formula equal to sign, selected the cell F76, multiply depreciation is 10, operator I am using divide 100. Okay, this is my depreciation amount. Okay, this is also one way. Second way also, I have selected cell number F76, multiply 10, and I am using percentage sign. Okay, please note that multiply my operator and percentage also my operator. Okay, so this is my answer. Answer become same. Okay. Now next operator are, operator is text operator. Okay. If you want to join two texts, Excel has given you command AND. But if you want to space between two texts, then Excel has given concatenate. So we'll do practice in our Excel sheet. Okay. In cell number B3 is equity and cell number C3 is capital. Okay. I'm using the command equal to, I'm selecting the cell and I'm selecting this cell. For joining two texts, I'm using AND command. Okay. But if you want to space between two texts, then Excel has given you concatenate command. The pronunciation is concatenate. Okay. Here my cell B8 contains EPS. This is a text, and in C8 numeric answer is 24. Okay. And if you want to join a two texts, that is one is text and another is numeric value. Okay. So I have given command here concatenate. I have selected cell number B8, I have given INR word and I have given a C8 cell number, that is 24. But if you want to give a rupees sign instead of INR, so I am giving a calculation here. Okay, the command is concatenate bracket open, selecting cell B8 comma quotes, I am giving space because EPS space rupees full stop, again I am giving space and quotes complete. Please note that I have not given any space in Excel formula. Also, if you want to give any data in alphabetical format, then you have to use quotes, and quotes should be used in both the side, in beginning side and ending side. Okay. After completing your alphabetical data, then you have to use comma command and you have to select your cell C8 and bracket close. Okay. This is your answer. Concatenate, my spelling is mistake, so I am correcting the mistake. Answer is here EPS rupees 24. Now here EPS is 30 rupees. See here my answer is changing. Okay. Concatenate command is used for joining two text, plus you can also consider the formula in concatenate. Okay, that is the best use of concatenate. After detailed explanation, we will take the summary of lecture. Okay, the summary of lecture is, first we understood arithmetical operators. Which arithmetical operators? That is plus sign, minus sign, multiply sign, divide sign, percentage sign. Okay, we have seen example also. Okay, that is most important, you should do the practice for arithmetical operators. Okay, so that your concept will be perfect. Next operator is comparison operators. Okay, that is equal to sign, less than sign, less than equal to sign, greater sign, not equal to sign. This operator is useful for logical functions. Okay, in logical functions we are using comparison operators. Okay. Next functions we have learned, that is text function. If you want to join a two text, if you want to join a two text, AND command is useful. But if you want space between two text, then Excel command is concatenate. Okay. The advantage of concatenate command is, the concatenate command is joining text and formula. Okay. Whenever any change in formula, Yeah, whenever any change in answer, automatically concatenate command will take the answer. Okay, if you don't use the concatenate command, then you have to do manually, you have to type your text, and whenever any changes done in earning per share, you have to do again manually, you have to insert the new earning per share. Okay, so Excel has facility to use concatenate command. Then our next lecture is, which are the date and time functions. Okay, how it is useful for MIS purpose, for data comparison purpose, and whatever type of different type of reports you can use date and time functions. Then logical functions, that is if and or. Then lookup functions, that is hlookup, vlookup, lookup. And last one is database function, that is minimum, maximum, average. So that's it for today. Hope that you have understood it. If you have any query or doubt, then please do comment on comment section. If you want to watch such type of videos, so please subscribe our channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss an update from us. Okay, until next time, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.